Well, I hope deep within my heart that you're having a good time and that you've already gotten what you came here for. You most certainly should have. But what a joy to be able to come from the world that just beats one up mercilessly. Our own mind does it too. I mean, it's just like, wow, it's a real trip. But what a joy to be able to come to a meeting, to be amongst your own, to get re-energized, revitalized, rejuvenated. And then, of course, back out into your life. Now, when you can master your life, we can get out of these lower worlds. So when you get supercharged like this, don't just blow it off. Take it back into your own unique world, whatever it may be. They're all legitimate. And do a better job at living your life, your own life. The heck with everyone else. Bless their hearts, but no, you're only responsible for your own state of consciousness, your own vibration, your own relationship with the master. And you got to pull this off. How did you absorb the last lesson? How culpable were you in your last experience? Did you get the truth that was being conveyed? Did you actuate that truth that was conveyed? Are you trying to live it? Or are you just going for the next joint or the next beer or the next lovemaking session to drown out your miseries? The choice is yours. So you must at least try and do the best job you can with the life you've been given. Now, please understand, any experiences that you're going through, and we've got some crazy ones. I know I've just in my own life, I've had some crazy experiences, ones I'm not even proud of. But that's the catch-22. Make sure you separate the experience from the experiencer. The experience will be long gone soon enough, but the experiencer, soul, you, your true essence, that's what moves along. So all these experiences are trying to dress you, the experiencer, in new attire. The new fashion for your new level of consciousness. And you want to wear it proudly. You want to be it. Manifest it. You just want to do the best you can. That's what the master is looking for. And make things the way you want them. If something happens and you don't like it, geez, you're kingpin, you're top dog in your universe. Rearrange it. Find something that smells nice instead of badly, that looks nice instead of ugly. Rearrange your attitude, your point of view, to make this, let's say, compromised experience better. You've got that authority and power. No one can mess with you but yourself. So use that authority. And what is being said here is that doubt, fear, uncertainty, desire, and the five passions of the mind are meant purely to compromise your focus. If your focus can be compromised, you're not ready for the higher levels of consciousness. I think that's very, very fair that Sat Paresh would ask this of us.